talking about all the king's men, story writing, 16, 10, 7. So how good is that for what it is? Those elements that they're covering, you know, that are confusing and complex and you don't have all the answers and there's a lot of blanks and a lot of names being thrown around. You know, that part is kind of difficult to follow along, but if you can just let go of that and just kind of sit back and watch the events unfold without trying to, you know, assign a name and a face to every event and understand how all those pieces fit together, then it's going to be a lot more enjoyable of a story. So that kind of leaves the question of, can a movie have a bunch of complex events and names and people and, you know, just a very complicated world and still not become like a business story or like a boring courtroom drama, which pretty much every courtroom movie is. You know, if you have all these boring business traditions and stuff. What they managed to do, though, is stay out of the courtroom the entire movie. There's never a courtroom scene. They give you a brief at the end of the movie about what happened to each person, what their sentence was. But really, it's not so much about what happened afterwards as it is, you know, about how it got started. It's not really even about the events in particular. as much as Woodward Bernstein's involvement in those events. The story's got a lot of variety. It's told well. You know, just if you looked at it with the sound off and just watching it visually, you'd think that it's a slow-moving movie. There's a lot of stuff happening, and it's more realistic, the pace of it, you know, to real life without it becoming just as mundane and repetitive as real life is. I'd probably say at least 86% for the story. I probably put it close towards like 91. So I'll just stick with 91, 92. the acting is excellent. But, you know, beyond that, the characters themselves are interesting to watch, too. They've got different styles of doing things, but they complement each other, like, really well, and, you know, I think that's what they were trying to go for, and that's what all the liberals drool themselves over, but they're missing the point. They weren't out to get, you know, just the Republicans. They were just trying to figure out what was true and what wasn't. And it just so happened in this case that, you know, there was a big network of stuff that was going on, and, you know, it was more about trying to overcome people's fear of Nixon and that organization than it was how powerful the organization itself was, because, you know, it wasn't, they didn't really have as much power as people were, you know, crediting them with, but people were acting really scared like they did have that kind of power, but they didn't, you know, he wasn't about to use violence to get what he wanted, he just was doing a bunch of sneaky, shady stuff. so long ago, I don't remember what was the case. I remember one of them was coming in new to the paper, and immediately, as soon as he got there, started challenging the status quo. Redford's character is the one that's more gentle and respectful in his approach, but he's still, you know, pretty firm on things, and he, you know, goes along with stuff reluctantly, but once he does, he's committed to it and trying to make it work as well as possible. And Dustin Hoffman's character is the one who act a certain way, or else it'll, you know, they've kind of got to do this social engineering stuff, and they're aware that, you know, if they're not polite and conduct themselves in a certain manner, the people are just going to clam up and won't say anything. So they have to do stuff really carefully and hide and have like a poker face. So it's a little bit like they're white hat con men. Because you know they've got ulterior motives to getting to the bottom of something, and they know what they can and can't do, but their real attitudes are secret, you know, and then they only show it off to, you know, their co-workers. So they're two different people, you know, one kind of person where, you know, they're one way when they're talking with other people, they're another way, like when they're just, you know, doing their job. He knows that what he's in is a business, and he's got to balance taking risks with trying to get the big scoop and trying not to get scooped by other papers. You know, and he cares about the issue too. But it's more about trying to stick with the integrity of the paper rather than the integrity of the people involved in the case. Repercussions. watching the interaction between the characters is well done. You know, they've got a good kind of crossover. You know, you've got characters who could hold their own as characters in a separate movie, but, you know, they bring them all together, and so it makes each one of those characters better fleshed out. You've got a bunch of secondary characters, and, you know, some are, I think pretty much most of them are well acted, and you get an idea immediately of what kind of a character they are, and that they've got multiple facets to them. So overall, I think the characters in the movie are complex, they've got good interactions, they've got a lot of variety. So, upwards of 86%. I just say 90. Got good arcs. You know, they realize their own weaknesses and kind of change the way that they do stuff a little bit. You know, they're each more careful. And I think they all learn lessons from what's going on. You know, the bad guys included. I'm going to stop this because I need to check traffic. Other stuff.